What's up, YouTubers? It is Keith, you guys. I am alive. I didn't die or captured or anything like that. It's been quite a while since my last video, and I apologize, guys. Now that things are kind of settling down, I'm going to let you guys know where I've been exactly and what's been going on in my life. It is personal, but I will share it with you guys because you guys, my subscribers, have been with me for years now. And I'm grateful for all of you who follow me and are subscribed to me still and have kind of been wondering where I've been. I appreciate your concerns and comments and personal messages, and I appreciate that fully. So, where have I been? As you guys know, I am now living in Florida, South Florida, and I've been here for about, I want to say, 5 years now, almost 5 years. And I work here and live here, and so that's where I've been here. You guys know that already. So let's get into it. Where have I been? Long story short, me and my wife have gotten a divorce, and that's what has been happening. As you guys know, I have 3 children, and I haven't made a video because anyone who's gone through a divorce knows that it's a very traumatic and hard thing to endure. This is my only marriage. I've only been married once. And sadly, now I'm a divorcee. I'm a statistic, and it's unfortunate, especially because there's children involved, and that's what breaks my heart. So that's what's been happening to me. I haven't made a video to touch on that because it was a very long, drawn-out divorce, and for personal reasons, and to protect myself and not incriminate myself, not that I would in any way, but I had to limit my my views and what I share, especially on the internet, that can be seen worldwide. So that's what I've been going on. Now, to tell you how I got to that point, we've got to that point. In California, I worked a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. I would be fortunate to have 3 days off a month. 4 days rarely. So I was a workaholic. And the money was there. I had a nice house, beautiful house. I had 2 vehicles, my motorcycle. The kids had food to eat. And there wasn't any shortage or any worries about that. The problem with that, you guys know, is that money doesn't buy everything. And with that being said, my marriage had a lot of problems. Not to mention the fact that I wasn't there involved as much as I wanted to be. Now, keep in mind that I thought I was doing the right thing by providing and taking care of my family. And as a lot of young husbands and young fathers later realize is that's not what is important. And I know that now, but I became a father very young, at a very young age, and I married not too young, but I still had a lot of growth to do and a lot of learning to be done. So I worked a lot and I was away a lot, and my family took its toll. And I'm not making this video to point fingers and say, well, I came to this place because of her, or my fault, her fault. It's not pointing fingers. I'm not going to do that. That it just is immature and foolish and doesn't get anywhere. A marriage takes 2 people, and 2 people is what it takes. So I don't like to be a quitter. I'm not a quitter. That's not my personality. I've never been a quitter. And I don't want people to be under the assumption that I quit or gave up on my marriage. That's far from it. Like I said, I was making pretty good money in California. I realized that my family was suffering, and that was a cause of a lot of arguments and fights and it took its toll on me psychologically. I felt a lot of guilt and regret, and I knew that my marriage and family was suffering, so I decided to propose to my ex-wife. Now, what could I do to salvage not just the family, but our marriage and relationship? She is from here. She has family from Florida. And she said she wants the kids to grow up knowing her side of the family, whatever family she has here in Florida. So I agreed. And so I sold the house, sold everything I've owned ever, and drove across the state, pulling a trailer with my motorcycle and tools without a job at all. I'm a tradesman, so I wasn't in fear of not getting work. But I knew that it was going to be a challenge. Moving over here, I can honestly say that I was hopeful and optimistic. That's kind of how I am. So I quit my job, which that plant is no longer a functional and operational plant. They closed their doors and they're facing a lot of lawsuits. So God works in mysterious ways. It was a good thing, good decision. And so I moved out here. I was fortunate enough to get a job and work a regular job 40 hours a week. With that being said, a lot of things came up. A lot of arguments and fighting were coming up. And I started realizing pretty quick that I wasn't to blame for a lot of things that I thought I should be at fault. And it began to open my eyes to a lot of things, necessities and things that were going on in my life and my children's life that were affecting everybody. My daughter, as you guys know, has sensory processing disorder, and that has been a big influence in me drawing close to my children. Not that I didn't have a good relationship with my children prior, but moving out here helped me grow as a father, as a man, and inevitably as a Christian. So a few years back, we started having problems again, and needless to say, my wife, ex-wife, left and for a while, and then came back, and this happened a couple times. And the last time, I felt a lot different. And before she came back, we set an agreement. We met at a neutral environment, and we established that things have got to change, and things have got to change like now. So we both set out goals for each other that we'd like to see change and growth and difference. And she said what she said wanted, I said what I wanted, and but we ended the conversation with that if these goals weren't met and we continued to have disagreements constantly, that we would give it a year, and we owed it to our children and ourselves that if there wasn't change in a year, we would split up, get a divorce, and coexist as parents. And that was a mutual agreement. So she moved out, took my youngest daughters, my daughters with her, and my son stayed with me. And it was very, very hard. It was very hard. I saw my kids on the weekends and sometimes during the week, during the beginning, and it was very hard because I worked, at the time, I worked second shift. So it was very, extremely hard. And going through something like that, you have a lot of thoughts that come into your mind. Now, as it may be, I started praying a lot. Now, I know some of my viewers, this may be a soft subject, but I'm going to talk about it anyway because this is an experience that I would love to share because it shaped it and changed me as an individual, as a man, and as a father. Before we separated, I started reading my Bible, like, daily. A coworker of mine was constantly inviting me to his church, which is Calvary Chapel, and I was standoffish to religion altogether, because I have a history with religion, and I will go into that in another video. Trust me, I will make a video about that. But I accepted his invitation and went to Calvary Chapel, and it really changed me. Mind you, me and my wife are still together while this happened. I, of course, wanted to share that with her because I knew that it would help benefit both of us. My ex-wife is a Buddhist, so the ideology is completely different, and that's okay. But I knew that I had to focus on my own spirituality. I was going through a lot, and it made me different, think different, feel different. And so I continued to read my Bible. Then we started having big problems. And of course the enemy works his way in there to try and create a muck. I endured. My marriage didn't. And so, end of the story is that she moved out. And I knew that was it. That was a year later, prior to our first talking to where we set these goals. So, you know, unfortunately, everybody deserves to be happy. Everybody deserves to be happy. And when you're in a marriage, you have to adjust and make changes. It's a relationship that is constantly takes effort and work. And you have to be humble, can't be prideful. There's a lot that goes into it. Most of you know that. But it does take two. It takes two. And it can't be 75-25. It can't be 60-40. It has to be a mutual effort. Unfortunately, we could not... It didn't work out that way. So she left, and I was going through a lot. I had my son here, and so I continued to pray and go to church. I was saved on August 8th and was baptized October 11th, which is 1 year exactly to the day that me and my ex-wife had that first initial talk about setting goals and we would give it a year. It was October 11th, and it was 1 year to the date that I got baptized. Kind of wild, right? Going through this process, my daughters were enrolled in a different school. The school that they were enrolled in, my oldest daughter, the one that, Sophia, that struggles with sensory processing disorder and issues, was having a very hard time. Now, mind you, the kids were also going through a divided house, which is very hard at a young age. My youngest daughter, Stella, just turned 7. So it was very hard, and it still is hard today. But at the school, my oldest daughter was evaluated towards the end of the year, and she was evaluated by the state, and she got a diagnosis, and they recognize her as being a highly functional autistic with sensory issues and sensory processing disorder. And she got her IEP, which is an individual educational program for kids that have special needs or have learning disabilities, which is a blessing. So that was a blessing. So I'm in the process of getting both my children, therapy, and my oldest daughter Sophia getting her occupational therapy to help her with her needs. It's very hard, you guys. It's been a very, very hard few years since I've been here. But things are, I don't want to say the dust is settled, because it's not. So, the day I'm filming this is August 2nd. And I just want to bring you guys up to date of where I've been. The divorce was finalized April 4th. So it's been a couple of months. But it was a very, I'm not going to lie to you guys, it was a very nasty divorce. And I fasted a lot, prayed a lot, and got a lot of help from my fellow Christians and my friends alike. And I was blessed to be able to have my daughters 50% of the time. So, which is a blessing, because I have them 2 weeks out of the 4 weeks a month. So 1 week I have them, the next week I do not. So it is a blessing. Of course, I would like to have them with me all the time, but 50% shared custody is a blessing. It's very hard. The state of Florida is going through a bill that would automatically give both parties going through a divorce 50% custody. You'd have to prove to the state that you would need more the other individual was unfit, or maybe deployed or in the military or whatever the case may be. But they're trying to pass a bill right now that would reward fathers and mothers going through a divorce 50% custody off the bat. So that's a great thing, because it's about time that the state and country recognizes fathers as being positive and influential role models in their children's life. And so Florida is catching on to that, and it's good. So that's where I've been. I could honestly tell you guys that becoming saved, becoming a Christian, is exactly what it is. You don't join a religious group. You embark on a personal relationship with your Savior. And I don't want to get sidetracked, because I know there's a lot of people that have their own views, and I respect that. And so I don't want to go off on a tangent, but I will say that this pulled me through. My relationship with my Lord and reading my Bible. I read my Bible from cover to cover in 1 year, which is hard for a lot of people, and it's easy for some people, but I did do it. And I've been around a Bible my whole life, but I read the Bible cover to cover, and I keep reading it. So it's helped me a lot, and it's benefited me a lot. But I will make more videos. This is kind of just a first video, me getting back on my feet, and I would like to commit to making one video a week. Of course, it'd be the week that I do not have my daughters, because I have the time to do that. Now, as far as my son goes, this was very hard for him, and he is living in California with his birth mother, and that's extremely hard. He's my oldest, he's a teenager, and it's hard being a father when you're over 3,000 miles away. So I try to be there for him as much as I can via text, phone calls, and things like that. So that was very extremely hard. But When we separated, me and my ex-wife, it was just me and my son. I was working second shift at the time, so it was hard on him. And his family, all his family, is in California. like mine. So it was very hard for him. And he's at the age right now where he can choose where he wants to be. He brought it to my attention last year that he would like to go try and live with his mother. And I prayed about it, of course. And I told him he can, if he feels that that's what he wants, that he can go and try it. And that was a hard pill to swallow. My son's been with me since he was four. Solely with me since he was four. And that was very hard. But I understand, and I wouldn't want him to regret me for it growing up and get drunk at a Christmas dinner when he's 33 and say, you never let me go live with your mother. And me be kind of like, what? When I was 15, you never let me go live with my mom. And I regretted you every day from that. So I don't want that to happen. So he's living with his mother. And I told him to really think about it, because that choice will have a butterfly effect on how he grows up in the rest of his life. And he understood that. He's a very smart kid. And so he's living with his mother in California. He's not a ghost. I'm not his ghost. I talk to him and we talk regularly, and we still have a relationship as best we can. Would I want him to be here? Yes, of course. And I'm his father. He's my son, my only son. So yes, my door is always open to him, and of course I want him to be here with me. But that's his choice, and he chose it, and he's a young man. He's very smart. So that's where I've been, you guys. I will make more videos about my religious upbringing and why I said I feel the way I did about all religion and religion together as a whole. But that's another video. Right now, I just want to let you guys know that I'm doing well. And although it was hard, I'm happy. I am a lot happier, actually. And I have a better relationship now with my daughters than I did before. And that's hard, because that's a double-edged sword. Of course, any children growing up would love to be with their father and their mother under the same roof. That's natural, and that's a natural feeling. But unfortunately, houses are divided. Now, a little bit about me. I grew up living under the same roof as my mother and her father. I had my mom and my dad, and they both were under the same roof, and we grew up like that. However, even though they were together, it was a divided house. And a lot of you can relate to that, but I grew up a very hard childhood. Even though my parents were together, it wasn't a joyous, happy, filled house growing up. So that's a saying that, you know, yeah, you don't know unless you live through it. Granted, there's plenty of households that have mother and father raising both all their children, and they're happy. God bless those families. Mine wasn't like that. So it's very unfortunate that my kids had to go through this and that are going through this continually today. But the more you grow, the more you know, the more you understand. And, you know, you just have to trust in God, pray, and you know, try the best you can day by day. So I am working. I'm still trying to keep in shape. I'm still very active in prepping and firearms training and all this stuff. So I'm still the same cat, but I take that back. I'm not the same. I'm a bona fide Christian. So, and you know, I'm not perfect. No one is. And that's okay. So take care, you guys. I appreciate your views and concerns and comments and support. I'm going to try and make a video once a week, and I'm going to start with this one right here. So don't worry about me. Don't worry about my children. Know that we're happy and that we're blessed. Yes, we're going through a trial and it's a struggle, but we will get through this. And time heals all wounds. And with the grace of God, it makes it a whole lot easier. So everybody's fine. Everybody's healthy. And I'm doing a lot better and ready to turn the page on the next chapter in my life and getting back into the saddle and making videos on YouTube and having that connection with a lot of you subscribers of mine. And yeah, so I'm alive. Ain't nothing happened to me. Fine. But I appreciate all the concerns. And I will see you guys in the next video. And remember, like I used to say in all my videos, that it doesn't matter what happens around you, but what matters is what happens within you. And I believe that. I strongly believe that. And I live by it. So take care, you guys. God bless you. Much love. And I will see you guys in the next video.